everybody. It's Invicta Time Continuing Streak here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance Series. Now we are only 9 days away from getting to All Alt Path Week, thanks to day before yesterday's video crossing 5,000. Yesterday's video has not crossed it quite yet, but it is very close. So definitely go check it out if you've not already. And thank you all very much for the continued support here as we go on into today's Eden Run. Hope you all had a great start to your day. Here's your meme of the day, artwork of the day, brought to you this time around by Sapphire Sage. And I got to say, I absolutely love this one. Tyler Thread was in support of Sin's Monster Hunter Stories 2 series. I've made this Invicta logo in my best approximation of the Monster Hunter art style. Hope you all like it. This is like exactly how I would picture my logo being if it was actually in Monster Hunter. So good job, Sapphire Sage. And thank you to everybody. Go check out the full resolution over on the Invicta subreddit. The slub reddit. Yes, indeed. It's going to be Zulu Bravo 9, Charlie Romeo Bravo, Romeo 0. We've got Contagion, just god-awful shot speed and tears rate. We also have Data Miner, which we could use to activate and re-roll our stats. We gave ourselves damage. 5.15 damage is not bad. Definitely would have preferred to have gotten a little bit of help on the tears, but I guess Data Miner could help us out a little bit. As you see there, Contagion does a great job at controlling early game crowds of enemies. I think we're going to be over here, maybe, possibly. Let's see. Okay. Look at that. That's exactly what I'm talking about right there. Secret room is there, and look at that. We do get Skinny on Mushroom, which is going to instantly increase our tears rate and our shot speed. For the low cost of just a little bit of damage. So, you know, that damage up that we got from Data Miner is actually pretty significant. Even have enough to get Mom's Key here. Very good start, I gotta say. Kind of a fan of this. But yeah, we're now only 9 days away from the like streak goal. Could not be happier about that. You know, and the way that the runs have been going lately, it feels like we've kind of turned a corner in a way. I don't want to jinx this now, and we all know that you probably shouldn't be saying this, but I feel like we may have a good string of luck coming our way over the next couple of runs. I don't know. I've been getting some pretty bad runs on stream lately anyway, especially that one. Those of you who saw the live stream on YouTube, you would have saw me just having just a horrible first run that we did. Old bandage, sure. Go ahead and take that. Let's go back and get that soul harp so we can protect ourselves. There we go. I'm not going to use Data Miner again. I feel like this is kind of like a blessing that we ended up getting a huge tears up and a shot speed up along with that damage up, so I don't want to ruin that. Omski, by the way, is going to increase the amount of items that are yielded by a chest. Yes, that is a Honey's Lozenge you're hearing. I'm getting better about talking with a lozenge. It's a hidden talent of mine. Gonna take Black Hole Sun, and hey, you know what, shout out to Data Miner, thank you very much for that shuffle. I would have stuck with that for a while until we got the stats that we liked, and I definitely like this stat, the start here, very, very strong. But anyway, I'm going back to yesterday's day before yesterday's live stream. We had just a hellacious start. I mean, it was just awful having less than two tiers for the entire run is something that's almost unprecedented in Isaac. You know, we get the good runs few and far between here, but when the bad is bad, it's real bad. I mean, we get three random items, so this could be good or this could be completely useless. I'd say that's pretty darn good. It's Stairway. So now money is our biggest objective here with Stairway. Stairway is going to give us a guaranteed angel deal at the start of every floor, which we can buy. We can only pay money for. So money, the focus of our money having ability is going to solely revolve around making sure we have enough money at the start of the next floor. Because you can't go back. Once you leave the starting room on every floor, that's it. That's, you can't go back into the angel deal. Black hole really good against Gemini. Locking them in place. We don't have to worry about the projectiles at all. There we go. Now we can go for devil deals here, but I think I want to double up on the angel deals. Oh, and you know what? Something else I just thought about here. With Mom's Key and Petrified Poop, I mean, the money-making abilities that we have potentially are very good for this. Like, I would actually like to see a golden chest come out of this Tinted Rock here. Oh, man. We're just calling it today. Look at that. We even get a sticky nickel that gets bombed for free. Wow. Is this like one of the luckiest starts that we've ever had? That's the thumbnail. Let's go into the curse room here. I mean, we might as well. We've had lots of good things happen so far. I don't want to jinx it, but like, you know, we're looking pretty good. Mom's Key again is going to give us a big benefit here out of this stone chest. Yeah, look at that. Look at that. Beautiful. We even get that half soul heart back. Wow. Wow. 30. We have 30 cents. We can buy two premium items in the next angel deal. I am going to use this. Well, I didn't mean to tap that, but reason why I did that is obviously because I'm just trying to get as much money as possible, because we know we're going to spend it the second that we get to the next floor. And why not? Let's go alt path here. We get our money back anyway. And a luck upgrade. Wow. What a start, man. So there's Stairway. Oh, baby. Now we cannot blow up this this angel statue here, but that's okay. Wow. Now just because we went downpour here, I'm not going to commit to fighting Mother on this run anyway, but I will almost guarantee that we're going to probably do a victory lap here just because we have Stairway. I mean, it's, you know, that's the thing when it comes to Isaac. Like, you know, you get a good item at the start of a run and you're just happy, you know. It just makes you want to play the game. And with Repentance, you know, the good and the bad are usually there's a pretty strong divide between the two. You know, occasionally you'll just get mediocre runs, but you know, when you're used to the kind of crap runs here and there, or you know, just used to them in general, it is quite refreshing, and it just puts you in a good mood. It just starts the day off right with a good Isaac run, and this one's certainly going to be that. Gotta say, I mean, I even alluded to it when I first started talking. I wouldn't mind getting the keeper here. Definitely need a Bomba. It's not a Bomba. The back out, back in. Okay, Min. I'm not going to use Black Hole for this only because we don't need it. Get damage upgrade here. We do not get an angel deal. I don't actually want perfection. And the reason why I held on to Black Hole is because I want to get these over. Yeah, although now that I think about it, I don't think we can actually access those, so don't worry. Don't listen to me. We could go fight. Really need a bomb. Will Black Hole destroy the Keeper? No. The answer is no. Ember's Machine. It could be pretty good with the amount of red hearts that we have access to. I also wouldn't mind getting a speed upgrade. We really have Birthright to thank for this incredible start, because without Birthright, we would not have gotten the stairway. Old Bandage, I love you. Look at that. This is, you talk about self-perpetuating money here. Man, oh man. Old Bandage is paying out like crazy. I love it. We're getting nickels, we're getting hearts, we're getting all kinds of stuff. What game did we log on to today? 58 cents now, we can buy anything to our heart's content. Again, I wouldn't mind getting a movement speed upgrade here. Pause for a second, let's go. I'm gonna go fight Min Min. But it's not because I'm trying to get the, key piece. I just want to simply get a second boss, because just because we're strong enough to. And it's possible we can get some bombs, and I mean, we don't really need bombs, but. But here we are in the upside down where we get another stairway. Oh yeah, it's the same one. I actually don't want to play this Judgment. I'll play it for one payout. How about that? Okay, that's all I wanted to see. I don't want to fight. I don't want to use any more money. I mean, I'll get the knife piece just because it's here. The Godhead aura is going to be crushing things. This early stage here, especially with a base damage of 5.0, man, and it's only going to get stronger as we get further and further into this run because of the fact that we've got stairway and a very, very healthy, strong economy. Oh, we can get us, we can get a crawl space that does. I don't think, have I ever seen him? I don't know if I've ever seen a reverse crawl space before. You know what's good when we're purposely actively looking out and trying to get extra boss items here. I don't know where Min Min went, but I'm glad that we didn't have to deal with that. All right, well, we get HP up, which is a little bit of a waste there, but wow. What a start. I'd call that start very muy bueno bien. Mooey. Spanish speakers of the mosh pit are like, no! The French speakers are like, no! Yeah, we even get ourselves the HP up that I wanted anyway, or the speed up that I wanted, regardless of that. So everything is, you talk about coming up Millhouse here, this is the grand champion of that saying, I tell you that. I guess we could take perfection. We're not going to be able to hold on to it for very long, though, I don't think. $0.62 here. We get Salvation, Eternal Heart. We get the Seraphim Transformation already, because why not? I didn't actually mean to buy that, but we got it. All right, at the start of a level here, I don't mind playing this Judgment. It is going to pay out with a guaranteed holy item, I think. I don't know if that's holy or not. No reason for us to buy that key, although I say that and now we just use two of them. So Salvation is going to give us a four-pronged revelation effect. Here, we do get the Bible. I'm actually going to take the Bible here just because I don't want it to show up again. It gives us a free mom kill anyway, so... But yeah. I mean, Black Hole is great for starting out, but we absolutely do not need Black Hole anymore. I mean, now I'm just waiting. I'm waiting for Arky at this point. I'm just going to be honest. Sad bombs. Pyro probably was a little bit better there, but if these fire guys spawn, like, I'm guaranteed to get hit by them, no matter where I am in the room. That's just something that happens to me personally. I don't know about you, but like those fire death rattle dudes, even though I know to look at the eyes to see which ones they're going to be, you know, if it's going to be crisscross or if it's going to be diagonal, I'm guaranteed to get hit by those. Like how you spawned right behind me there. It's pretty clever. Anyway. No reason for us to be in there. This early flying is going to be very helpful as well. Okay. Augatory. Oh my goodness. Did you see how bright? Did you see how absolutely like lit up Uriel was there from Sad Bombs and the overlapping Godhead aura? That was just incredible to look at. An eraser. Again, I'm going to stick with the Bible only because I don't want to see it show up again for a while. Super secret rooms got super secret nothing. Maybe Singe? And it goes, we were able to get back into the angel deal. Yeah, we'll take Crow Heart. Better than losing Soul Hearts, I think. Yeah. All right, Stairway, what we got this time? We get the Wafer. Wafer, holy card. And again, might as well play this Judgment here. These keys actually might be pretty helpful as well. Remember, we've got Mom's key, so every chest that we open is going to be potentially huge. Lots and lots of money to be had. Okay, well, we don't really need another HP upgrade, so I'm just going to ignore that. Thank you for trying, though, Judgment. And use the Holy Card, even though it's probably already wasted, but, I mean, come on. If we lose our Holy Mantle here, I don't think it's going to be that much of a problem. We've definitely done more with less. Let's put it that way. Now, I don't know if the red heart damage that you take from Crow's Heart does that override your Hey, Akodama. Does that automatically cost you your Devil Deal? I wonder. Cool card. We'll go ahead and take. Now, we're probably going to go up from here, from Ash Pit, to start with. I could go get, if I really wanted to, actually, I'm going to drop the Crow's Heart because I actually don't know. I don't want to lose our Angel Deal chance just in case. Yeah, we're going to go up here from Ash Pit. Look at the multi-dimensional baby tears we have from Akodama. There goes our holy card there. Again, we want to basically have as much money as possible for the next floor because of stairway, blah blah blah. Yeah, I mean you know the game plan by now. Look at the size of Salvation. Salvation's aura is gonna get only bigger and bigger the more damage we take. And this is the maxed out Salvation. Already back at the 56 cents. It's as if that didn't even happen. I was buying that angel deal. It didn't even happen. Oh my gosh. Just look at the range of Salvation. That is incredible. Pentagram, which is going to give us more damage. I do want to try to make boss rush, especially since we have this fool card. Victor, you dropped the fool card. Yeah, I know. I mean, piggy bank is solid. Oh, man. What's going on with these bomb placements here? Yeah, we'll come back and get the key piece on the next, when we're actually ready to go fight Mother. Right now it's not my priority. We're gonna do another run, don't worry. Because there's no way I'm turning down an entire run filled with stairway. Gonna try to max out our money here. This is the reason why I decided to pick up the piggy bank, and this is definitely gonna be worth it with the anticipation of us having a guaranteed angel deal every single time we go to a new floor. I mean, this is just too good not to pass up. I think that's time again for another lozenge. Which I dropped on the floor yet again. This is not Godhead, it's the Angelic Prism, in case you didn't know. I can't tell you how many lozenges I've dropped on my carpet. Just because, like, as soon as I take the wrapper off, it just flies out at, like, the fastest velocity ever seen in the existence of space and time. And I just butterfingers it, and it just goes right there. Alright, these judgments I'm a little bit disappointed in, not gonna lie. Angelic Prism, though. I have a long way to go to get to Mom. The whole point of this was so we could get a boss rush here. We only have 30 seconds to do so. We have to hope that we get to the Mom fight. And this is the right way to go. Which is not, of course. Well, we might still make it. We're able to make it. We're going to take the negative. D100, no, thank you. I'm actually going to take spilled milk. I'm going to take milk here. Tractor beam, while it would be kind of neat with Godhead and stuff. Oh my gosh, look at the... I didn't know that could happen. Akeldama with the Angelic Prism. Who knew? Not me. Definitely would not mind a PH Dizzle appearance. Boy, howdy, did we fail spectacularly. Looking for that angel, that item room in that store. Thank God we weren't on a time limit for this part. Already back to 79 cents. Which means that the store and the shop are adjacent from one another. So I'm going to be lazy here. Just use two bombs instead of just using one. And that will almost get us to 99 cents again. I'm getting a luck upgrade here. Already touched, no thank you. Before we go play that, let's go beat greed real quick. The Steam sale, which does indeed affect our stairway prices. Oh man, heck zero with this build, good lord. And now it's really good that I didn't take tractor beam. Again, I wouldn't mind getting a little bit more shot speed, even though it's counterintuitive to Godhead's purpose. It's still like just a little bit more, just a tad bit more shot speed. Our soul heart back here. Man, if you wanted to see one of the most crazy perfect starts ever, then here you go. This is seriously insane with how good our luck has been on this run. $0.98 going up to a stairway. We get Crown of Light too. Holy. My word. All right, Judgment, I know you can pay out with something other than HP. I've seen it happen before. I believe in you, son. All right. Blue map's going to show us the way. They're in the nick of time. Crown of Light's going to double our damage whenever we get full HP. I need to go pick up that red heart, actually. The reason why we're not having the Crown of Light effect right now is because we're not at full HP. Now we are. See the crown lighting up here. Do you see the huge amount of damage that we get? And that combined with Contagion, as you just saw right there, is going to just be sick, nasty, crazy, stupid. A Crown of Light will dissipate and cancel itself if you take damage of any kind in a room. And it will be gone for the rest of the room, regardless of your health, of how much HP you have. So you really don't want to take damage ever, but it's even more so, even less so than with Crown of Light. Oh my gosh. Amagurdi did not make it. No. I'm sorry, we can't. There's literally no reason for us to. No. No, we can't. Oh my goodness. All right, Judgment. Not gonna lie, you've been letting us down a little bit here, son. We need you to not give us the bean, and we need you to not give us HP. That's what the team needs from you right now. Can you do that for us? Can you deliver for us, son? That's all we want. Not asking a lot.
Judgment.
We're not asking a lot. We're just asking for just a little bit. Just a little bit. Anything other than HP. Alrighty. Jawbreaker is not bad. Especially with this luck. Try that again, shall we? Try that again, shall we? Broken hourglass is definitely tempting here. Get the IV bag instead. You do this inside of the hollow ground field, as you see right here. We're getting the damage negation. And I don't really want to play this claw machine, but at the same time, we have so much money. We almost have no reason not to. Yeah, we even win it in one hit, and we get the D-Sizzle. We get the D-Sizzle. Get the D-Sizzle. Get the D-Sizzle. We even get the D-Sizzle. We get the D-Sizzle. We even get the D-Sizzle. We're even gonna get the D-Sizzle. We're gonna get the D-Sizzle. We're gonna get the D-Sizzle. We're even gonna get the D-Sizzle. Look at that. Beautiful. I mean, here's the thing about Dr. Fetus and Godhead and Sad Bombs. That could be pretty insane. But you can't fire this fast is the thing. Okay. Well, we got our money back. We've lost our Crown of Light, obviously. But we can get it back, though. We did get Revelation as well, thanks to the stairway. Pretty difficult to tell what's going on right now. Another angel deal here. Fortunately, the D6 is not charged yet. We'll take the relic. And I think it would behoove us to at least get a full charge on the D-Sizzle. We're heading on down to the next floor. And money is not a problem at all on this run at this point. It hasn't been for a very long time. There we go. There we go. Got a charge on the D-Sizzle. Let's go see old Usher. I will admit that having Dr. Fetus would have probably been a little bit better. What we've got right now for old Hushy. Oh, man. Well. We're going to take the Star Bethlehem for sure. And we get the Holy Mantle. Probably should have waited to use the D-Sizzle before playing Judgment, but I was just too excited to see Holy Mantle that I just couldn't help myself. I'm sorry. All right, Judgment. Now listen here, son. You're getting another shot here to perform for the coaches, all right? We need you to come up with a big-time play, not give us HP. You're going to not give us any kind of bum friend. You're just going to simply pay out with a holy item, and it's going to be great. Gimpy. You take school bag. Should probably deposit here as well. Even though this is going to hurt our... I was hoping there was going to be a full charge in here. This is going to hurt our next level economy. I didn't go down that much, so. Take blue candle just for the fun of it. I'll just run for show. And look at the damage we could have if we had the Star of Bethlehem with us. Alright, old Hushy. Really difficult to see where the incoming tiers are. Trying to hit the prism with revelation whenever I can. Most revelations I've ever heard of, ever. I don't even know what's happening anymore. This is madness. Yep. My God. I'm just gonna sit here and face tank. We have the wafer. Don't forget about that. I think Hush is hurting himself when he spawns the flies more than he's hurting us. That was ridiculous in the best possible way. Thank you, old Hushy. Thank you very much. Unfortunately, we don't have a reroll for this, and we get monstrance as well. Man, I mean, they're all here, right? They're all here. Look at the damage that we get here with the Star of Bethlehem. Which way are you going, Star? Are you going up? Going up? All right, Stanley's over here apparently. Not over there. All right, Uncar. We might as well use that. Why not? We get our crown back. What kind of light that is. There's even a library in Shoal, of all places? Man. Really is a blessed run. I am going to take the Book of Secrets so we can, excuse me, keep some mapping. I'm not going to use the D6 in here, mainly because we're not going to be able to get a full charge before we go to the next stairway in Shoal, or in the Dark Chest, I mean, and I want to have a reroll ready to go. I mean, this run right here, you just can't help but smile and feel good. Yeah, good luck stomping on a Stanley. You don't want to know what happened to old Hushy. Yeah. Absolute destruction. Not the greatest. Dead Dub also not the greatest. Yeah. Hey, good. I was worried about it automatically making me take that. The thing that this run started with Data Miner and it just morphed into something ungodly good. Not even ungodly, just really good. Belly Jelly! We like Belly Jelly here. Especially when combined with Holy Mantle, we've got a lot of defense, a lot of offense, we got a lot of everything here. I actually have a reroll here. Hang on a second. You know what I'm thinking. You already know what I'm thinking. Okay, we get rid of all of our HP. Not that it's going to matter, of course. It's going to require us doing a full clear of the chest, but for very good reason. And man, we even get Spoonbender. Spoonbender is actually not that great for Godhead, but it works most of the time. The reason why it's not that great is because it makes the Godhead tiers curve a little bit faster. And as we all know, Godhead tiers don't do real great contact damage against stuff. D and Fizzle. Got the D and Fizzle. Keeper Sack is quite good as well. Don't know if we're going to have enough for another full charge here. Gonna try our dangdest, though. We know that the Star of Bethlehem will be waiting for us in the lamb fight. Oh, Mr. Mega over here. How you doing? Brother Mr. Mega? Didn't mean to be so rude. Looks like we will have another chance for a second or an R key. So don't go anywhere. We might be looking at it. We might be looking at something special. I mean, we already knew this run was special, but could be extra special. Oh yeah. Was so close. That's okay. We tried our best. We still came up with a D Infinity. Gonna have a whole nother run to get it. Yeah, goodbye, Lamb. Goodbye. Second run of the day. Kilo Bravo, Cabra. Hotel Quebec, 9 Romeo. And we get Divine Intervention as well. Brand new run, brand new day. And Curse of Darkness with this. This is rough to look at. Titanic Bibble. Not going to use it, but I'll touch it. Definitely one counterfeit penny for this. Absolutely. I can piggy bank. I don't think it stacks, but we can pretend it does. So much money here as well. Remember, we still have stairway, so we're going to have plenty of rerolls. Stuff. And since this is a brand new run, the loot tables get reset. Get ourselves a toothpicks and we'll head on down. All right, stairway. Look us up. Yeah, not what I would consider hooking us up, but thank you for trying. There's a soul heart back in here. We'll take, we already have another charge on the D Infinity. That took us all the way to the boss room? Very weird, very strange phase or maze there. We get the Yes Mother transformation. We don't even need angel deals, to be honest. I mean, yeah, we'll take Eye of a Cult. We'll take the Eye of a Cult. An Emperor card, nice. Because we're still going to get angel deals anyway, thanks to us having the stairway. So there's, we've pretty much already gotten all of the items that we would want out of an angel deal. I cannot think of one that we don't have yet. That, well, I mean, okay, there is one. There is one, the only one that matters. You know which one I'm talking about. And it ain't the jar of everything, I can tell you that. Spectral Tears. Yeah, we can take Spectral Tears. We passed up on Dead Dove, so only natural. Gonna hold on to this Emperor card and we'll head on to Zaun. Second Star of Bethlehem, I'm pretty sure it doesn't do anything. We do need to get our key back though. Thank you. What we're really keen on is finding an item inside of the secret room for our key. This would not constitute either one of those things. A daddy long legs here. Daddy! Are just there's things just exploding everywhere. Sure, we'll take Sackhead. Really no reason for us to take the Card Against Humanity. Get a full charge there for strategic re-rolling purposes. We definitely don't need Speedball. We definitely don't need more HP. Gonna save this re-roll for the next stairway. go get our second key piece. Gotta go Pogatory. We passed up on Pogatory once. I'm sorry, Pogatory. Never again. It's actually not true. I'll probably pass on you a couple times. I have a cult causing us a little bit of problems. It's just kind of what it does. The stapler, which is going to give us a nice damage up. Definitely needed to be doing more damage. I don't know if you could tell. Did you hear about this? Did you see this? I mean, it counts as a guppy item. Yeah, as a Purgatory actually broke their shell. We do get another devil deal. By that, I mean Krampus. We have not been to our item room yet on this floor. Go find it real quick here. And again, you just got to sit back, relax, and just enjoy the finer things in life. This, which in this case comes in the form of a Binding of Isaac repentance run, because man, oh man, powerhouse runs lately. And again, I think it goes without saying that we needed something like this to happen. We've had a couple of powerhouse runs already. Get double tech zero here. No big deal. No big deal. Just me and my double tech zero. Just flexing on them haters. Gonna buy a full charge here just so we obviously have a way of re-rolling for the next floor, which is gonna be happening, right? Blood puppy, fine. So it's a shame that we didn't have a full charge for the next floor. I would have loved to have been able to re-roll that, but hey, you know, sometimes that's just how the mob flops. And we'll head on down to the next floor right now. I don't think Crown of Light stacks. Does not. Blood Puppy, you're gonna have a very hard time getting fed here today. And honestly, I'm not gonna apologize for it. Been a bad puppy lately. Been a misbehaving puppy. Yeah, we're starting to run out of options here. We're starting to run out of time to get an item in the secret room. Also, I recognize that like we haven't used the Book of Secrets at all. And you know what? That's just how it goes. of the eraser. Eraser's going to give us a chance to erase one enemy from the entire run. We got to make it count. Sure. I'm still looking. Do we actually get all those? Did not. Well, you know what? I'm going to bomb my way in anyway. All right, so let's go get the second key piece here. Also dawned on me, we don't have the second golden key piece either, but we'll definitely get it. Stairway is going to make sure that that's taken care of. We got old Hushy down. We got Stanley and the Lamb down. Mom and Mom's Heart, of course. Not at a good angle for us right now. That's much better. The most perfect like bomb throw ever. Oh, I'm gonna have to disagree with that one. I don't know about that one, game. Are we still not through that wall? I feel like we got away with one that was much, much, much closer. Oh, wow. She charged us from like a mile away there. Oh, whatever. Let's go see what's inside of our third, or our, not third. Go see what's inside of our secret room. We're going to go get our Emperor card back. Being able to teleport out of the mother fight is going to be important if there is... There's a lot of things that... Oh, here's the button. There's a lot of things that have to go right in order for us to get the all clear full house run. We absolutely need to get... God, I hate that. We absolutely need to get a Gnar key, though. Curse of Blind, hooray. Sure.
Holy cow.
Now what sucks about this is if we do get an item inside of the secret room, we won't know it. We won't know what it is. You still get the Steam sale from the Keeper. Missed our eraser, it's good. Any pack is all right. Get Hungry Soul. And movement speed. It might be our last resort. We have so many holy items that we might as well take it. Not going to use it right now. Obviously. Olak, it's excellent here. There we go. Another soul heart for us to boot. Did that on purpose so we could get some stat ups from Soul Locket. Okay, so we have Genesis, and if we have to use it for the chance to get Narkey, we will. But there's going to have to be a lot, again, that's going to have to be a lot that goes right for this. And mainly, namely, us getting a teleportation out of the mother fight and getting a sacrifice room. That's what we're going to be looking for here. Well, hang on a second now. Now, with the mystery gift, we can spawn an item inside of the secret room. And that's all you need when you're talking about an item pedestal. Let's not accidentally hit Genesis. Well, I really do hate how the D Infinity resets like that. I feel like that's more of a bug than anything. I mean, I know why it does it, but like, I think it's dumb that just because you put it down, just because it's the D Infinity, you just lose all the charges that you had built up. Yeah, we have our reroll ready to go. Lost contact is good, but not what we're looking for. Absolutely not. But it would double the amount of items Magic skin would double the amount of items that we get inside of the secret room. Just by sheer virtue of just existing. Yeah, we have a D6 charge again, so we have two item pedestals in there. This might be the last reroll we get. The Eternal D6, which we don't want to use. Don't think we're going to get another option here unless we get a full charge or something out of these sacks. There is a full charge here. Rock bottom. Let's see if this dice room is a global D6. And in the room D20. I'm trying to get these coins out of here so I can open up that sack. There's a charge key in here. Okay, we have one more reroll, I think. He's done it! Oh my gosh, now I have to dodge the space bar like nobody's business. Is it possible? Could we actually get our second chance this early? After the heartbreak that was. And the game crashed. I think the game crashed because of us standing inside a Star of Bethlehem. Please don't make me have to redo that entire level game. Are you kidding me? That's annoying. I don't even remember where we got Genesis from. We got Genesis from Stairway, and we didn't get Stairway this time. We got Genesis from Stairway, and because the game crashed, we don't get Stairway this time. That is some grade A Isaac BS right there. So I don't think I'm going to pick up Rock Bottom next time. Just to prevent us from crashing the game again. This freaking game, man. I mean, I'm beyond... I'm not even surprised anymore. I'm just annoyed that we have to do this all over again. Especially after we just got done getting such a great victory right there. And having to do all of this over again is just a... Anyway. We know the charge key comes out of there, out of that sack. We're going to leave because we already have the reroll. But it's going to be on the second reroll that we get it. Yeah, because the next one's going to be the Eternal D6 and then Shielded Tears and then Art Key. I'm pretty upset over... Did we lose Stairway? No. So we still have a chance of getting Genesis back. Oh yeah, one of them is going to be Rock Bottom as well. So I'm not going to take Rock Bottom just in case if that's what caused us to... I have a feeling that's what caused us to crash. Okay, so now we've got our R key back. I'm going to exit. I'm going to exit the run now. Not the run. I'm just going to exit the level for now. Just so we get the save state, just in case that crap happens again. Because I don't think it's fair that we should give up. We should give up rock bottom. If you're going to put an item in the game, I expect it to work. The only bad thing now is that we're down Genesis, and Genesis was a key point in having both Genesis and Arky, because that potentially is our second Arky in there. And we really need to have a full charge here for the next stairway. I think we just skipped that. Okay, we have everything. Got everything. We got our teleport. We got our key. Okay. Try this one more time. I'm going to stop firing. Okay, we're in. All right, we better be getting our Genesis back here, game. How did I just had a feeling. Mm-hmm. Oh, you know what? We don't have our second key piece either. Not that it really matters, though. Okay. Well, and buy this. So here we are. Once again, Genesis down, but there's still we're back to our original problem in the almost ultimate Isaac run. Which is we have to pass the Mega Satan RNG. That's what has to happen. So what we need to have happen, not on this floor but the next, we need to A, hopefully get Genesis, which probably won't happen, and B, we need to hope that there is a sacrifice room in Corpse 2. If there is, we can get out of the mother fight without having to use R key, and that is a big deal, because then we don't need Genesis technically. Well, we still technically kind of do. We have our broken heart here. There we go. Thank you. This is Corpse 1. It doesn't matter if we get a sacrifice room on Corpse 1. We need one on Corpse 2. Get a devil deal. We can take Horror Babylon. Super bandage, I think we'll pass on. All right, moment of truth. We need a way out. We get Revelation. We potentially are going to have four reroll pedestals to get Genesis in here. There's one. Because it doesn't matter if we have our key right now. We're going to be able to get more. Right now, the more important thing is getting Genesis. Because potentially we can get a second. The whole reason why we're doing this is so we can potentially get a second R key From rerolling. Obviously, we don't want to use Genesis while having the Archie, because then, well, the Archie's gone. So Genesis is kind of like more like a backup plan. Very funny game. Okay. So, if there is no... If there is no... sacrifice room on this floor, we still have a chance of getting an R key by way of Genesis on the next run, but we are going to have to use our R key here to get there. That's a forget me now. Now, what that means is that we get another floor so we can beat Mother and get out of there. We can actually beat Mother, get out of here, and restart the floor, giving us a second chance to get a sacrifice room to get out. That's assuming that the Emperor card takes us. I'm pretty sure that the Emperor card takes us to, the room before Mother. I don't think it actually keeps us inside of the Mother room. I'd feel a lot better about this if we just simply get a different teleport card. I don't think we're gonna get one though. God, every soul, he just scared the hell out of me. The world is exploding. Still a small chance that we could get a sacrifice room. Okay, so we don't get a sac. We don't get a sac room. If I really, 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 really wanted to, I could use those full charges and reroll this. I could reroll consumables until they turn into a different teleport card. The D20. Arch key, okay. The only thing I'm doing here is I'm simply just looking for a teleportation card. Hermit card would potentially take us to the same room, but I hope it doesn't. Okie dokie. Does the hermit card take us anywhere special with tarot cloth? Turn shop in order to teleport you to the shop. Why did it have to be a hermit card? Let's try to reroll that hermit card, because I actually don't trust the hermit card here. Open up the sack first. Reroll. Do we take the hermit card or not? I'm almost positive the Emperor card does not take us into the Mother fight. I'm pretty sure it takes us here. And that's the logic I'm gonna stick with. The whole point of us getting out of this room is just so we can get to the 5 room and spawn another, have a second chance at spawning a sacrifice room. The whole point of that is to prevent us from having to use the R key. Of course, the only downside to that is that, of course, we may lose the R key on the next run. Okay, we were able to get out of there. We can go grab the Hermit card. Just because. There's no way for us to get another full charge, I don't think. Unless that was one in the curse room. Mini one. That's okay. We're not going to have a reroll for the angel room, and that's perfectly fine. That is not what we wanted to see. It was just nothing in here. So now all we're looking, the only thing that we can do now is hope for another five room or the sacrifice room. We've already beaten Mother. Mother's done. Yeah, we have no way of, we don't have Nun's Habit either. We have no way of charging this. Do we have Nun's Habit? I don't think we do. Pretty sure we don't. Okay. So, sacrifice room. That's what we're hoping for now. Got 40 damage. Pretty good. Oh my god. The sound of all of the moment of truth. There's no sacrifice room. So we're going to have to use the R key. That's the only way that we can do this now. There's no reason for us to keep going here. So there's no dice room. The only item that could help us at this point would be Forget Me Now, which is, I don't think it's possible for that to spawn. But we got our key once, we can do it again. All right. Let's rip it. Let's go into the super secret room first, just in case. Yep. Is there a tarot card that would help us? No, I don't think so. I don't think there's anything that we can spawn spikes at. Yeah, we're just going to have to use the R key. All right, here we are. Cabra, same seed. And that is the Soul of Eden. That is not the Star of Bethlehem. So we are going to need a second key piece here, which we are, again, going to guaranteed get because, well, we've still got Stairway. Roll. We get the mind, which I will take. Duality. Duality is actually not bad here. Duality at least gives us a chance of getting another angel deal to hopefully spawn Genesis. But since we restarted the run, it is possible that we can get another R key. It is totally possible. Doable, in fact. Okay, so the goal for this run here is for us to get to Delirium. Might as well get our second key piece here. But again, that's going to heavily hinge on us. Maybe we'll get a full charge. That's going to heavily hinge on us getting past the Mega Satan RNG. We've beaten Mother. We need to beat... We need to go up to Blue Baby. Beat Blue Baby. You know, taking Magic Skin may not be a bad idea. I hate to say it. But we're already deadlocked into having Magic Skin. At least this way we can guarantee that we get... At least we can guarantee us getting an item pedestal inside of the secret room, which greatly increases the chance of us getting an R key. Pretty Plum. Oh, that would actually... Bird's Eye is great, but I don't think that it's wise with this build. I honestly think that we would have crashing issues again. Okay. Okay. So we have two item pedestals in there. We can get restock or something like that. Just anything that can give us a full charge. So for this run, we're going to have to go regular. We're just going to have to beat. We have to beat Isaac, Blue Baby, Mega Satan, and then hope that Delirium spawns, all while holding an R key. Which sounds like a lot. That does sound like a lot, but it is doable. It is totally doable. I'm not going to use a reroll here. I will take Miter, but I'm not going to use a reroll. We already have our second key piece, I think. Yeah. Let's use this reroll in the secret room. If we get an R key, then we're happy. I'm going to use Magic Skin again. No. DM Trainer. DM Trainer would not be good. I'm going to full charge anywhere. I really don't want to have to keep using Magic Skin. We have no more. Yeah. Just going to have to go. That's okay. We've got plenty of chances. Holy Light. Now Genesis, let's curse the XL, of course. Genesis is another way that we have a chance of getting another R key. So there's multiple ways that we can still do this. Not sissy. What's the Lover's card do? Spawns one item, the cool pool, one two swords and a broken heart. Adds four broken hearts, spawns four items. Yo, I ain't scared. Let's do it. Take us to the secret room. This has to be it. If we get an R key here, then we have a chance. Okay. Sharp Straw, you know I love you. Here's the hoping that we get a confessional booth as well. Okay. I'm gonna not use. We don't need to use magic skin anymore. I think that that's a waste of time at this point. We're just looking for soul. We're just looking for full charges now. What a great retribution this would be. What a great comeback story. To get so close to the full house run of repentance, not get it. And in the same week we have a chance to get it again. Maybe full charges in there. Just because we used R key, I think we should still have a chance of getting another R key. I think. I don't see why it wouldn't be showing up in the item pool. Lucky Penny. Come on, Lucky Penny. I mean, it's still within the realm of possibility there, because we did see Keeper Sack. That's not a sentence that I ever want to say ever again. Dark Bomb, I saw that spider. Don't think because we got a winning run here doesn't mean you're not under evaluation here, Dark Bomb. You're still under evaluation, son. No more full charges. We could spawn one from the keeper. Actually, no. You know what? We still have the mob trap room. Come on, this has got to be it. Secretly hoping that we spawn something that gives us a full charge. Like a charge key or something. My gosh. I didn't even realize what it was because there were so many spiders. Come on, game. We're working hard here. I mean, we could take Glitch Crown if I have to. I'm pretty sure that we're still within the realms of the possibility here. We're going to have to take Glitch Crown most likely. All right, I've done all I can. Glitch Crown. I don't even know if we want Echo Chamber. That's the kind of run this is. All right, well, we have Glitch Crown. And even though we're not going to get, I thought that it would roll there. Even though we're not going to get it on this floor, it was a good attempt. But with Glitch Crown, that almost guarantees that we're going to see Genesis again. I'd be shocked if we don't see Arky or Genesis again. I'm just going to take perfection. We're still working, team. There's Genesis. A beautiful, beautiful item. We can't bung this up. I overthought it. I overthunk it. I got too close. Performance anxiety. So now the question is, what's more important? Getting the item pedestal inside of the secret room? Or getting the item pedestal inside of the angel deals for Genesis? I feel like the secret rooms give us a better chance at getting an R key. But this means that we're gonna have to use magic skin again. I really didn't want to have to do. Yo, can we get some enemies though? Hopefully we don't, this is a one and done situation, and also hopefully I don't bung up the glitch crown again. That's death certificate, which we can get Narkey from or Genesis from. Get rid of this foul thing. Making it nice and slow. Oh my God. All right, Sissy! I have no idea. This is nerve-wracking. Without seeing how large our hitbox is, Monstrance is really screwing me up here. Never been so nervous to move around one room. Before you ask, yes, I have used death certificate to get Sissy. The problem is that I don't see Arky. Arky's supposed to be in that previous room. Not this room, the other room. Unless if it's not static. It's supposed to be in that room in the upper, at the top of this level. I'm getting a little nervous now. There's redemption. Dodo not see Arky. Before we go in the big room. Yeah, this is odd that we haven't found it yet. It has to be in here. I don't even see Genesis anywhere. There it is. All right. I'm gonna back out of this run just so we don't have to do that again. The only thing I'm doing with this is I'm creating a rerun, not a rerun state, but a return point here, just in case, because we've already had the game crash once. I do not want to have to do that again. All right, the rest is up to the game. Now, I am still going to look for Genesis just in case. Because that way we can potentially have a chance to get another R-key. Means that we need a full charge here. Absolutely wild week of runs here. I cannot believe that we're in this position once again. The battery actually wouldn't be that bad. I feel like I'm so nervous now about moving. I'm like, can I touch anything? I'm trying so hard not to hit the spacebar item, even though it doesn't do anything, but I don't want to lose this opportunity again. But again, it still comes down to making the RNG happen from Mega Satan. That's the only way that this works. I think we should reroll this now. We might get a second chance at Genesis here. Nope. I don't think we're gonna see Genesis again. Okie dokie. Keep it going. All we gotta do is beat Isaac. There's the blind array. All we've gotta do is beat Isaac, Blue Baby, and Mega Satan has to give us a portal. Or we find a way out of the Mega Satan door and declare that if we do get to Mega Satan to phase two, which we undoubtedly will, We can declare that a victory and not give the game a chance to screw us. But we need to get away. We need a teleportation card to get out of the the Mega Satan door. Emperor card would do that. Actually, now that I think about it, we can probably go redeposit stuff, but I'm not keen on doing another 3-hour run here. Let's just get this done. All right, we're taking the Polaroid. We've taken the Polaroid. The item pedestals aren't even, they're not even moving anymore. It's just all magic skin, literally. Yeah, the only way we can see Genesis at this point is using our key. Now, I realize that we haven't done boss rush yet, but that's not going to matter. We can do boss rush again. We can simply use the R key and then just do a victory lap real quick. Because remember, when you use R key, it does not reset the run time. It's just gonna be all magic skin. So what we need to happen here is we need Blue Baby. If Blue Baby gives us a portal to Delirium, we've got it, because I'm going to arbitrarily declare that if we get Mega Satan to phase two, which we will, I'm not going to give the chance for the game to screw us. So we have a legit shot at getting this done. I mean, this doesn't even matter. So if Blue Baby gives us a Delirium portal, we've got it. Because then we can go down, fight Delirium, use the R key, come back out, do a victory lap because we're not going to be able to get boss rush. Victory lap, boss rush, beast, done. How sweet it is. I think Tech 1 would actually be great for us. Not Tech 1. Blue Baby, we're counting on you. The reason why I said Tech 1 would have been good for us, it would stop the visual diarrhea that's happening right now on screen. The moment of truth. If Blue Baby gives us a Delirium portal, we've got it. There's no sacrifice room in the chest, so this is it. Now, somebody said we could use the R key before the animation of Mega Satan ends. And I will use that as a last ditch effort. But I would much prefer Blue Baby just to give us the portal. I think we've earned it. Here we go. He did not give us the portal. So now it comes down to Mega Satan. Do we try to use the R key? We could try to use R key during phase two. We're in phase two here. And it does work. Mega Satan down. Okay. But the problem is that we need another R key now. We know that we can get to Delirium. Now the question is, can we get Genesis again? Because I think that's the only way that we can get another R key at this point. Because it's just going to be magic skin over and over and over again. But we can also combat that by doing a victory lap, which we're going to have to do anyway. Oh, good lord. We do not want Ipecac here. I'm not even going to attempt that. I mean, Ipecac would be incredible, but I think that would actually break the game. We get Diplopia. Then restock. That's all right. We got Diplopia, so that's good. I didn't think we'd be able to reroll those. I don't think we're going to see Genesis, though. I mean, this doesn't really matter. Sack Dagger. Don't do this to me, game. Don't give me another chance. If we get another Arky, we could Diplopia that in there to give us more pedestals, but... If we get another full charge... We do not want car battery. My gosh, is that magic mush I see? Eagle's power wouldn't be... Well, actually, my Eagle's power wouldn't be very good. Take Eden's blessing. Really wanted to get a full charge. I hate to waste a an item pedestal inside of the secret room. Especially one that we didn't have to get via... Via the magic skin. We're gonna unfortunately not be able to reroll this. Unless this has a full charge in it or something. Okay. That's all right. We'll still have chances. We have two more runs to get an R key. We're now only one R key away. We're only one R key away from the run. We just need an R key. That's all we need. Because we can R key, we can guarantee on the victory lap, we can guarantee the delirium fight, R key out of that, and then just go fight beast, and that's it. That's literally it. Okay, we potentially could get some items in here. If the key beggar is kind. How are you not paying out with anything? Could D20 all this stuff in here too. I mean, it is an item pedestal. Okay. I have full confidence that even if we don't get an R key on this run, we'll get one on the victory lap. And if we don't, then we'll just do another victory lap. It's happening. Must have ran over a full charge or something. I'm determined. A breakfast isn't a good sign. That means we are out of actual items here. Which is very strange considering that we have we ever gotten an R key on an R keyed run before? I'm starting to doubt myself. Yeah, this is all breakfast here. Okay. Okay, so our journey is going to take us to probably Genesis, I'm guessing. If it's not possible for us to get another R key on an R keyed run, then we have to hope that we either get Genesis, which we haven't seen since R keying. So that makes me think that it isn't possible. Once you've seen one, that's it. And the only reason why Genesis is even important here is just because it's almost a guaranteed second R key. That's the only reason why that it's even like a thing of importance. We're not trying to continue the run. All right, so I'm gonna hold the reroll for the angel deal with Stairway. Oh, we're getting super super strategical now. Now, I severely, sincerely doubt we're going to see Genesis here if we've just been seeing breakfast and magic skin. Yeah, I don't think it's possible. And hey, that's okay. That's okay, because on the victory lap, we've got Diplopia. We have Diplopia. We can use Diplopia inside of an item, inside of the secret room, or inside of the angel deal to force Genesis or Arky. I think in that spot you got to use it to get Arky. I would assume anyway. I think Brimstone actually ruins this. I'd love to get Brimstone, but I think it actually ruins what we've got here. Yeah. Yeah, we're not even getting regular judgments anymore. Okay, so we know the plan now. Victory lap. We go victory lap here. And then it's look for R key time. But we have to get the R key on the victory lap. Or Genesis. Either one. Of course, I would much prefer R key just because it's the surefire thing. Note to self, we're going down on the next floor. We're not going up. Going down. And I know I could have taken that chance to let Mega Satan try to give us the portal and we wouldn't be in this predicament, but I don't want to give the game another chance to screw us again. All we need is our key. That's all we need. I'm not going to go to the sac room because we quite frankly just don't have enough HP to do it. I was kind of really hoping that we were going to see another confessional booth and I just don't have to worry about the whole empty heart thing, because then I could easily take magic skin and then we can practically guarantee it at that point. Unless if it's cumulative, which I guess it... it could be cumulative for the 12. Magic skin was the reason why we were dying in that first run. Okay, we're going down here. We're going down. We have the negative. We're going down. I want to get rid of this. Oh, there is a confessional booth here. That's okay. That's no problem. We got rid of a lot of the empty hearts. So we could take magic skin now, but I don't think we should. Because we give up Diplopia. We take magic skin now. Let's say no. We're gonna see it again. Let's not overthink this. Let's just go get our victory lap done, and then we'll worry about that. Look like we're playing the midsection to one by Metallica. Look at that. We restored some of our HP. I love it. All right, I was kind of looking for a confessional booth. Okay. I have a good feeling, Mosh Pit. I have a feeling that this is all going to be worth it. Oops. Let's not do that again. If that had been missing, no, I would have been very upset. Sir, you're dead. Thank you. Absolutely like to do a victory lap. You kidding me? All right. 10th run of the video. 1 Alpha Bravo Hotel, Romeo Hotel, Juliet, Charlie. We have now the potential to get what we've been coming for. I'm not even going to bother with going after our key until we have like a double full charge on magic skin. Although magic skin is just going to show up nonstop, apparently. Which is kind of the reason why I want to get Genesis. See if we can get the victory, or if we can get the mystery gift. Oh god, here we go again. Would not mind battery, baby. Unfortunately, that takes all of them out of there, so it's good to know. Now we cannot, we can't dilly dally because we need to be able to get boss rush here. It's a pretty big floor. It's just magic skin for days. No item pedestal in here. The thing is that we can get magic skin pretty much on demand at this point. So that's why I'm not in a hurry to use it yet and then Diplopia and go for rerolls. I want to do it on a big floor that we have plenty of options to get more rerolls out of, because that's going to be the most important thing. Charge key there. Get that dime real quick. I'm hoping that the angel deal just hooks us up and just gives us Genesis. Now, I don't know, does the sacred orb reduce the chance of our key showing up? We already have one sacred orb. See if we can get rid of more empty hearts here, because we are going to need to use magic skin even more. We've got rid of all of them. Great. Super good, super good. I say we go for a reroll in here. Not see Genesis, so we're going to reroll again. Sacred Heart. We'll take Sacred Heart, of course. Okay, let's not bung that one up. When it matters. Let's not bung that one up when it matters. Let's go back and get our double full charge here for the D Sizzle. By the way, shout out to the D Infinity. I mean, really, you got to give it up for the D Infinity. Oh, God. Lead Pencil. I think I psych myself out more when I just sit there and wait and wait and wait. I think I just need to go in, count it once, and then just grab it. Don't overthink it, just grab it. Oh man, we still could have rerolled too. Darn. Darn, darn, darn. That's all right. We gotta remember boss rush. And really, we don't have to do boss rush here because we're still gonna have to do it. We're still going to have to do it on the Beast Lap anyway, or we have a chance to do it anyway on the Beast Lap. So we don't necessarily have to do boss rush this run. I don't know, man. That's an early. This is a pretty early magic skin. There it is. There's the R key. It's right there. It's right there. I thought it would double it. Well, there's death certificate right after it. Just get the R key. All you gotta do is get the R key. He has done it. Let's do it, Mosh Pit. Let's get out of here and just do it. Boss rush into Hush, into Delirium. R key beast done. No. We just go. We send it. We don't even care. We don't need anything else. We don't want anything else. We know what we got to do. It took 2 R keys and 2 hours and 17 minutes, but we're going to get it done. As long as they don't accidentally click missing, no. Or use the R key. Let's not even joke about it. Let's just get it done. And you know, I gotta say, Magic Skin, the play was solid. Using Magic Skin to force R-Key is a very powerful, very, very, very powerful strat. I have no idea where Star Bethlehem went. Don't think it was this way. Was not this way. Watch us get nothing but Curse of the Lost.
Nice mind, nerd.
And the game crashed. Oh. Clap, clap, repentance. At least we know we have the R key, and we know exactly where, well, we don't know exactly where the boss is, but we know where our Star Bethlehem went. Fortunately, we got our broken hearts back. Which is pretty lame, but the game's doing everything it can to stop us at this point. We're not gonna let it. Whatever, man. Curse of the Blind, of course. So here's the problem with Curse of the Blind showing up now. The problem is that Missing No could spawn in the boss rush. That's the problem with Curse of the Blind showing up now, of all floors. Was not Missing No. Thank you. trying not to hold down the fire button too much because I don't want to crash the game again. Boss rush into Hush into Delirium. It was only 2 hours ago since we beat old Hushy. And we're going to beat him again to force the Delirium spawn. And the game crashed again. Ed! Fix your game! I don't like all these crashes. All right, we know what we gotta do. We know which one to take. We know which one it isn't. Yeah, we're only gonna fire once. I guess there is something that the game can still do. Honestly, I think it's Angelic Prism that's causing it with Tech Zero. I think. I'm just gonna fire once. I don't even think we need to fire. I think the spiders and flies are going to take care of pretty much everything. Nope. Not even touching it. I'm not even going to be tempted by the idea of looking for Genesis. There's no, we have everything we need. We literally have everything we need now to do this. There's no reason to deviate from the course. Dark Bum going to have a field day. Happy for you, Tom. Debatably, I probably shouldn't have picked that up, but that's okay. I think Brimstone would actually be smart, because I think that it is Hex Zero and Angelic Prism that's causing the crashes. So if I get a chance to take Brimstone, I probably will. Let's do it. Oh God, I'm not even gonna tempt fate with Infestation 2. Good enough. Let's just get it done. Old Hushy. We're back, Hushy. Remember us from 2 hours ago? You're not going to stop us, game. You will not be able to stop this. You will not screw us out of this. You will not. You know where we're going. The knuckles, they be cracking. Does Star Bethlehem go to Delirium? I actually don't know that. Let's test that theory. I guess it does. This is no longer your game. This is my game. Delirium down. And we go one more time. The funny thing is, we still have time to make boss rush. What a journey. What an absolute journey. No commercial breaks, no stopping. We're just going to do it. I want this to be done. The crowning achievement of, I think, repentance. Because it's so dang hard to do. At least naturally. I mean, I guess you could do it with Tainted Cane, but I'm talking about using only the spawns that the game gives you. Not using console commands, not using mods. Not using Tainted Cane or anything like that. And there may be some that have done this before. There may be some that have done this in much quicker time. Which I'm sure there has been. But personally, I feel like this is the crowning achievement. Getting a repentance all kill. Mother. Isaac, Blue Baby. Ush, Delirium. Mega Satan, Satan, Lamb. Boss rush, all of them, ending it with Dogma and Beast. Probably should take a mom's knife there. Oh, we don't even have to. We don't have to fight. We can just go. Curse of Blind, we don't care. Not gonna give it a chance. Now the only thing I'm worried about is this. Is that people were saying that the last time we were in this position and the game hard locked, technically soft locked, the game locked up was because we had already killed Mother on this run. Didn't actually mean to pick that up. That was dangerous. But I'm pretty sure that that doesn't matter for this run because we're on a totally different run than what we killed Mother on. Yeah.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
That was the only thing else that I was worried about, and I didn't really want to mention it, but we did get hard locked in a room where that we could not get out of, where Dad's note was supposed to spawn, and it was because we had killed Mother on that very same seed. But this is a totally different seed because we did a victory lap and then Arkeed. The seed had nothing to do with that Mother one. I'm taking Mom's knife only to stop us from crashing again. Oh my gosh. Look at the damage. I wonder what Revelation looks like now. We've already seen the lost child, so I'm not sure what this is going to turn into. Probably just another rotating item. I keep having, like, I'm second guessing myself and thinking, like, did we really get all the bosses? I'm counting them off in my head. Hush, Delirium, Isaac, Blue Baby, Mother, Mega Satan, Lamb, Satan. We got them all. Mom's heart. Second Mom's heart. Delirium. Now Dogma and Beast. And we still got Inner Child. Take that, game. And have you ever had a problem with Dogma? Consider this your revenge. Oh, you know what time it is, Mosh Pit. You know what time it is. We're just gonna let it play out and enjoy this victory. It was a long time coming. What a journey. I think it's safe to say that we earned the title of Ultimate Isaac Run. All bosses down in repentance. You're thick and thin, no mods, no console commands, all of it legit. Not even the game crashing could stop us. Cue the metal. Round one. Oh, Famine's already dead. He's. We got Blood Puppy. The only thing we're missing is Little Sissy. Can we really call it the Ultimate Isaac Run without having Little Sissy? I don't think so. Yeah, War's already dead. The Ultra Horsemen aren't even getting out of the starting blocks. Not even close. Mother is not gonna last very long. And she died without even getting to phase two. Wow. Wow. Thank you for watching, everyone. If that one doesn't get your like, I don't know what else I could do. If you enjoyed that run, please consider clicking the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Thank you for those of you who have been supporting me throughout the Repentance release and beyond. We're not done. Not by any means. Isaac will be here forever, and so will I. Yeah, if you're not subscribed to my channel here, please consider doing so. If you saw this video on Reddit or on other various platforms, please check out all the links down below. You can follow me on Twitter. Check out my Patreon campaign, which I'm going to be reading out in a moment. You can even have your own names read at the end of an Isaac run, just like these next fine following people. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like RickRue59, McMannon, Glenn McKenzie, Medic Wolf, Squeegee, and Daniel Molinar III. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/sinvicta.